guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video on UMRV. We are continuing on wheat harvest. As you can see, he has made his three headland passes and is working on his back and forth passes. We have a second full truck already, so I have already filled this truck once and dumped it, so we are going to come over here and dump this truck again and keep that combine rolling. So the wheat is not doing too bad. I did notice going in this menu, I don't have any wheat stored technically, but if I go down here to the production chains, you can see our wheat is going up in our grain dryer on our productions menu. So but definitely is going into the silo. So I'm going to get this thing dumped. We should be pretty close to 3,000 bushels already. It's like 1155 that this combination holds. Roughly a little over 2 grain cartons to fill the truck and trailer. I have been debating. I actually haven't priced it out, but let's go take a look here. It is under this one. And what a old Chevy truck would run us. But so we would need 50,000 for that truck. 50, and then if I were to get the Mauer trailer, could get this one as well, but I think this one would be a little bit more accurate. So we would need 100,000, or we could lease it, which I think is what we're going to do. We're going to lease this guy 2,000, and then go over here to trucks, and we're going to choose the Mac. Put the dual stacks on her, and then we will lease that as well, just to kind of help speed this along. We did have a dealership sent out our way. Well, that's all right. Okay, so we'll pull this guy right here, and if we go here, we should have a truck and trailer. Perfect. So, we're going to go ahead and get this hooked up and get it out to the field.
Breaker 1-9, Breaker 1-9, I'm stuck. Might need some tow chains. Come back.
Just to kind of help speed things along. so much time running back and forth with just that little truck and trailer setup that we got. This is probably kind of the setup that I'm going to upgrade to. Something like this. Maybe I'll get one truck with a mower trailer and then get another truck with the Mac, the grain trailer for the Mac, from the, I think it's called the Mac grain hauling pack or something like that. I can't remember the exact name, but the pack of Mac.
10-4, I'm right back at it.
Very nice pack. I like using it starting out with these smaller setups. It usually kind of fits right in. Let's go ahead and dump right on into this hopper trailer. Not even quite full grain cart. So I'll save. So, this is going to be your Saturday video. I'm actually recording this like maybe a half hour after the previous video. And, but kind of recording a bunch of videos and uploading them ahead of time. Sometime this week, possibly Monday or Tuesday, I might have another video from at work. We just got our new fertilizer system in for our corn planter. Along with a bunch of parts for our air seeder, so I'm going to be working on that quite a bit. Went and got our parts on Thursday. Yesterday, for you guys watching this, we had a cardio from our local John Deere dealership come down and worked on assembling this new fertilizer setup, take a peek at it. They brought down a few more items, took back some other items. They brought all of our seed boxes back for the corn planter. Testing them, making sure they were calibrated and ready to roll this spring. And they were good to go. So they brought those down, brought us a barrel of oil. That's going to be another thing I have to do, is changing oil on the 9630 that we have on our corn planter. I already got the air filters changed out as well as the fuel filters. I just have to go through and I have to pull the oil filter yet and drop the oil and then get it filled back up with fresh oil, put a new oil filter on it, and then can prime it a few times to get the fuel filters filled, and then be able to fire it up and let it run that fresh oil through it, and then I did some work on putting some new parts onto our cart, on our air seater, and got that finished up, so the cart is ready to go. And then got a few things done on the drill section of our air seater. Still got some work left to do on that. So, got a lot of work left to do, a lot of work ahead of us over the next couple of weeks. Finally, well, we're not technically done trucking for the year, but we are done with what we can. The elevator that we've been hauling our wheat to is currently full. We won't be getting a train until sometime in March. So we are kind of at a standstill on that. And then my boss and his son just hauled the last two loads of sunflowers in for right now until June. Filled this big contract. He does have another 500,000 pounds of sunflowers contracted, but not taking that contract, anything for that contract. I believe he said until June. I could be wrong, but the point where I remember what he said. Kind of at a standstill on trucking for a while. So those are going to get put away. Earlier this week, we had one of our conveyors go down. It shredded the belt that runs the hydraulic pump, and it somehow is completely out of hydraulic. It's actually ATF. Completely fill that conveyor, and then also have some extra on hand because we realized that we have not checked our other conveyors to see kind of what they're at for a level on fluid. And so at some point when we have the space to do it, we're going to bring that conveyor down to the shop, and we got to track down a belt for it first. But then we will put a new belt on it and get her filled back up and make sure everything works and see if we can't figure out why we are completely out of hydraulic fluid. Something, not exactly sure what happened there. We didn't see any on the ground, so we know it wasn't leaking. But it obviously went somewhere. But that'll be a later project. Perfect. Be pretty close to full by the time he gets turned around. Well, I guess he's not quite 3/4 of the way full, but he's good enough for us to unload him here. Just trying to get this down. We can get turned around and going. We have a couple more of these long passes, and then I believe it's going to break off and go up there first. quite hilly. Trailer only holds 750 bushels, so it's not a very large trailer by any means, but it will get the job done. What we got in here, so we got 3,060 bushels in our silos. This was a larger scale operation than we've seen in a little while, but for the size of operation that we are currently running, it is actually a pretty decent amount. Alright, I'll leave that guy sit there. I'm going to grab this tractor. Get up to us and get unloaded. Popped off and start dumping on the trailer probably. Truck is just about full already, so it's 62%. I think what we're actually going to do here is once we finish this field, jump over across the road, get 34 done. And then once we are done with field at 34 and have everything taken back to the yard and whatnot, then we will go ahead and get our baler out to get it going, because we're going to kind of have to babysit him a little bit. So I'm sure that baler's going to fill up fairly fast. Or what we could do, I guess, too, is we can. That's what we'll do. We'll finish this field. So I'll probably finish it off camera, and then in tomorrow's video, I should say, we will get that baler rolling. We'll see how many bales we get off of this field. And I'm kind of shooting for about the same. I guess I haven't really looked to see just how many bales I've made. 527. So, made quite a few bales between hay and grass. Let's jump over to 4440 here. Let's get this guy out and let's get it hooked up to that baler. So let's see. I don't remember how many bales. I never checked of how many bales were on it when I got done with our hay. So we had 293 grass bales. So we'll try and get around that, 250 to 300 bale range on our straw. So if we can get around that area on this field, then we can just go ahead and chop the straw on field 34. Because I don't want to make like 400 or 500 bales, just hundreds of bales. I would be hauling bales forever at that rate. 16 bales at a time. End up trading off that small off-road trailer, big snack trailer that was built. That 16 bale trailer hauling a couple hundred bales will just take forever. Filled up, and I know for sure we're gonna fill that trailer yet. We might fill one of them one more time yet. So, quite a decent yield. Can't really complain. Should be able to get a decent amount of money out of this. Start selling. Fall. It's probably going to be just before snowfall, mainly because I don't want to blow snow all the way from here, all the way down into and through the town, just to sell grain. I will blow snow in this yard. I'll blow out the road all the way over to our cow farm, but that's kind of about it. And then obviously clear out the cow farm, but that is about all. I don't plan on going all the way. Kind of sit and wait for him to get full, which I guess he is half full, so let's go ahead and unload him just so he can keep on rolling. Have him stop as little as possible. Storage facility right now, but down the road as we expand and start producing more, we're not really making a huge dent in our wheat. Now corn, on the other hand, it's hard to say. We might have quite a bit of corn to where we would need to move it, but for the time being, we have plenty of storage space. We aren't quite that big of an operation yet, to where we need more space. So still have 864,000 liters. I kept filling until I maxed out their total capacity, so maxes out at a million. Didn't need to go that high, but at first I didn't know just how much they would go through, so But I think that's going to be all for today's video. Like I said, I'll finish the wheat on this field off camera, and I may get the baler started, have him start going, and in tomorrow's video we'll do a little bit of baling and hauling some bales, getting them stacked. So yeah, I think that's kind of the plan for that. But if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you are new to my channel and have not already done so, be sure to subscribe and stay up to date on all uploads. And be sure to tune in tomorrow for some baling and bale hauling action. What we got off of this field in the end. Do a video of baling. Continuing right back on with some wheat harvest. So,